Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. We'll begin with biblical, biblical foundation. There are two biblical foundation. Foundation number one is the, I don't know, Tata, what's the easy way of telling you? The doctrine of man. In theology, they call it anthropology, the doctrine of man, or the teaching of the Bible about what a person is. Maybe that's a simple way of the doctrine of man, or anthropology, or what the Bible says, what exactly is a person. And let's read Genesis. Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, 2, 3. The first foundation, or the first part of the biblical foundation, teaches that man is created as a whole. As a whole person. The word living soul. Living soul in this text, and soul in many other places in the Bible, talks about a living being or a living person. So what the man is believe that the person is a whole. And as we know, it's divided into four aspects, or they call it four dimensions. What are they? The body, or the physical dimension, whatever. The spiritual, the mental, the emotion, and what's the last one? Body, spirit, mental, social dimension. Social dimension. In the study of men in the Bible, it talks about the fact that men are a soul, or person and a soul, body and a soul, as a separate thing. I think Tartar knows that this word soul comes from several Hebrew and Greek words. Ruach. Nefesh. There are many words where this word soul comes from. Both in Hebrew and Greek, it means the whole person. Many churches or many Christians still believe that soul is something separate. But the health message of the Adventist teaches that the person or the living soul is a whole being consisting of all these four dimensions. And anything that affects one affects all. That's the other. The lecture teaches that we are created as a whole. We are created as a whole. We sin as a whole. We die as a whole. And we will be resurrected as a whole. As a whole person. We will never die. And when you die, your soul will go around and enter into something else. But it will remain on the ground until the second when Christ comes back. We will come and restore the whole person. Restore the whole person. So that is the first part of the biblical foundation of our health message. The second part of the biblical foundation is the law. The Adventists believe that when God created man, He submit men to a number of laws, not only the Ten Commandments, but all natural laws, all the laws. Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. Exodus chapter 15 verse 26. Let us read 2-3.
Lecture, it says that two things
Kaya lang walang class to recommend this other message. Although she expands the Bible and what Abago talks about her, there's two things she does. One, the letter uses this, this word. Systematization. Systematization of the evangelical message. And two, he talks about the proper application. Of the teaching of the evangelical message. But what exactly is this? What is it? Very, very simple. What Ellen White does, she organizes the message of the Bible into four major categories. Systematization. Is Ellen White's effort in organizing the purpose, the goal, the content, the method of teaching, and the application. Over the message, or the lecture calls it contextualization. Which means that you cannot take a message to everybody. You have to tailor it to suit each person. Places, depending on what they get, the level of money they get, and so on and so forth. Many times when we make a health message, we generalize and apply this, it applies to everybody. But we find that Ellen White, in organizing the Bible message on health, she categorized them clearly and carefully under this topic. So in the area of application, we find that Ellen White also teaches about how you should heal people. I think Megan West knows it. Water therapy, how you should use water, and many other applications of the message. She also clearly defined how you should apply. Not only teach the knowledge, but how you should actually apply the message. There are many ways which are now being practiced by so many health champions or teachers, but Ellen White is very clear in her message. It's important for us as Adventists to know how she teaches the method of application of the various methods that is found in her book. So that in very brief terms, what is the spiritual prophecy foundation of the Adventist health message and the contribution of Ellen White in our health message. And it's important that we know the foundation. And it's unfortunate that we cannot go into detail in each of these, but it's interesting to know that sometimes many of the things that we are doing are not in accordance with what. In a way, not only Adventist wants it to be done, but in the way Ellen White actually said
the peace should be done. That's important. So maybe at some stage later, we can go into this detail, in more detail. The third foundation, which is the second last part of this lecture, is the scientific foundation. I think all of us know that faith and science don't work. They don't agree in many aspects. Because religion sometimes is faith-based. And you cannot prove it through scientific method. Because that's what the Bible says. And you need to believe it. And many times science cannot prove. Science is not trying to prove that this world is what? Created. And many times there is a lot of disagreement in that aspect of the Bible. But what Adventists found out that in the area of health, science and faith are beginning to work. They are coming together. A lot of studies are being made, which now confirms the Adventist health message. I don't have time to share with you the study that has been done all over the world, not only on what Ellen White says, but the study done on Adventist, a way of life, to confirm that Adventist message and the practice of health is supported by science. So what can we learn in this part of our lecture? The WHO, you can only go to the World Health Organization, because that's where all the minds of science, matches. When you look at the definition, this is what they say. Health is a state of complete physical, mental health and social well-being, absence of disease or infirmity. Sounds familiar? It's coming close to what? Our biblical foundation. The WHO, this is where all the minds of science in the world, when they quit together, the definition of health for all the world to follow, this is what it is. That health is what? Health is, I like this word. Health is what? Complete. Same as the teaching of the Bible, then what? Soul. So is somebody, is a complete person. So is a complete person, no different. But it says, complete of what? Physical, mental, and social well-being. Nearly there, but the small shot. Science, but it's coming together. It's coming together. Science is believing that the person is a whole thing. If you don't take care of your health, you will your spiritual health will also be affected. If you don't take care of your health, your mental health can be affected. If you don't take care of your health, your social relationship can be affected. But what we are talking about here, that science has now become closer and closer to the Bible definition and to the Adventist health message, that health is complete, same as the doctrine of man, that soul is complete. One dimension affects the other, affects the other. We die as a whole, we sin as a whole, we what? They treated as a whole. And when Jesus comes, he will come back. He resurrected as a whole. And now, here and now, God promises that in the new birth experience, what is promised was? In the new birth experience, Jesus also promised what? A complete person. Because any man being in Christ is what? New creature, complete, new creature. All things are passed away, complete. So here now, we too can enjoy this completeness. We too can enjoy the promise of John 10:10. That abundant life is given to us if we accept Jesus into our heart, the Lord and Savior. But many researches have been done. And I don't have the time to share with you some very important research. About breastfeeding. Ellen White talks about breastfeeding. And research have confirmed that breastfeeding is the best way to what? To feed at a certain time. Two, pre and what? Post? Yeah, the ladies, I have not an expert in this. I have to share with you what I've been taught. So it is found that this is the best time to look after the what? Babies, from conception, before birth. The weight of the baby is very important. It's what you feed the baby at that time. Tell him how he talks about it, and science tells him. She was speaking well before her time. And now science are beginning to confirm that what the baby's teachers is true. That the care of the person covers the whole full life cycle. From birth to death. Science also talked about breakfast. And so many interesting research done on breakfast and diet. And it's the same as what Mary said in teaching. For those of you whose work is more office work, they emphasize breakfast. And the importance of making decisions, making the right decisions in the care of life, everyday life. Our life choices, our choices of practice and behavior, science. May a lot of researchers in this area and confirm what they are being said in teaching. And we thought, as we discussed earlier, that when you obey, the way. And the way goes wrong, you have healing. When you disobey, this is coming to us. So those are some of the areas which researchers have now confirmed what the Adventists have been talking all this time, including what Ellen White has been teaching or has written over the years, well before our time. So finally, the final part of this seminar or lecture is the education. It's the education foundation. Of the Adventist health message. How should we promote health message. Remember to wash your mother or anything to the people. There are two ways. There is adequate way or right way. And there is an inadequate. Inadequate way of promoting. So what is the right way or the adequate way of promoting health message? There are three ways Adventists believe that we should be sharing and teaching this message. One, by what? This lecture teaches the health teachers that if you don't have experience, don't teach this message. Don't teach. If you don't have experience in this message. Second, if you cannot example it, you cannot example health message, don't teach health message. It's a wrong way or inadequate way. Or it's a wrong way to teach if you don't have, you can't speak it by example. It's a wrong way to teach if you have not experienced it. And the third way, you have to model it. It has to be a role model in the community, in the church, in the family. That is the right way of teaching. Adventist health message. This is the Adventist teaching, the fourth foundation of our health message is education and the way we should promote it. But what are some of the inadequate ways? Some of the inadequate ways or the wrong way of teaching health message. One, fanaticism. We have talked about that. What does this mean? Being a fanatic, you overemphasize it. Overemphasize it basically, this is the gospel. I come here and I tell your brains and tell you to be a vegetarian. As a result, I forgot about the gospel. Fanaticism. And many times, the brain is having a involved in those areas, fanaticism. Second, proof of discipleship. Proof of discipleship. God's message is not proof of discipleship. Many times we force it home, that if we don't practice, you may not be in the right church, or you may not go to heaven. Proof of discipleship. This is a wrong way of promoting. Third way, third wrong way, critic. Many times we criticize people because of their health behavior. Adventist teaches that you should educate in what? In love. Educate in love. They may not understand you. They will come a time maybe, but as you share with them, same love. You should not criticize them because of their state of health they are in. Imposing change. Another wrong way. Imposing. Imposing change. As you like to critique, like you are forcing a message. You present it in such a way that you are forcing a message. And sometimes we, without thinking about it, can be using a forceful, promoting words. It's good to promote that message, but we should be careful not to go beyond the balance. Should not go beyond the balance. We should not impose change. Then finally, there's a wrong way. Generalization. what's the generalization? We make exceptions, the one. The rule. Yeah. One example given is, this is what it talks about. Don't mix vegetable and what? And fruit in your meal. But when you look carefully to the context it was written, she was talking to those who had bad stuff. But instead of applying it in the right way, we use it generally, and then we force it, and then we use each other. But we should be careful not to make generalizations. Okay? Make exceptions to the rule. Another teaching is about milk and effort. Sugar. This is what it says. Don't have it in your dessert. And then you look closely to the planet. She's not really imposing it as a rule. She's not imposing it as a rule. She, in some other writings, says that you can, but it applies to certain specific situations. But what we are talking about here is we need to be careful about generalization. So that friends comes to, I'm now closing up this lecture. And the question I want to pose to you, how are we in our understanding that I have got this health message? How do we apply it in our life? How do we share it and teach it and promote it? And I hope that in what we have said together, it could help us in a small way, in the way we teach, practice, and apply the meditation message. Thank you for listening. That concludes our session today. Any question or anyone wants to add in any of this discussion? I will speak again on this in the main program in the AY, but I will be using the PowerPoint that time. So hopefully we can revise it again and discuss more about some of the things that will come. If there is no question, let's bow our heads for prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the church. We thank you for giving this church a message that you want to share to the world. We thank you for the health message, and we thank you for the things that we have shared together today. Many of these things are new to us. Many of these things may not be fully understood, but we pray that in your own time, in your own way, as we go back and apply your message in our lives, may your Holy Spirit guide us to apply the message in our lives so that we may be changed to be like you, and also we can impact others to see you do. In this message, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.